Jake here for Extreme Terrain, and in this video, we're taking a look at the AFE Momentum GT cold air intake with the ProDry S filter in red, fitting 2016 to 2023 3.5 liter Tacomas. If you're looking to add some more power and sound to your Tacoma, look no further than the AFE Momentum GT kit we have here. This is a really well-engineered kit that provides you with more airflow than stock for more power and better induction noise too. There isn't always consistency when it comes to cold air intakes, but one thing that is consistent are AFE's offerings in the space. This one in particular is no exception, and it's got some pretty cool features built in. Now let's address what is definitely the most obvious, is that this thing is bright red. This goes beyond just a pop of color in the engine bay, makes the whole thing into a big statement piece. Now, if the red is not really your jam, this is also available on our site in black, though with that kit, the scoop is sold separately. However, this one is, of course, not all about aesthetics. Now, the idea of a cold air intake is to funnel more air and cooler air into your engine so it can breathe better and thus make more power. Now, that is accomplished here on the Momentum GT in a few ways. Now, on the side of the air box over here, it's gonna pull in air from the factory location within the passenger side fender. But this will also pull in air from the front of the truck into this kit with a big scoop from the front of the grill. Now that means that the air is gonna be cooler and that's gonna make for better combustion. In fact, AFE claims up to a 34% increase in airflow over stock with this kit. Now part of that is due to this gigantic intake that we have right here. Again, this is gonna mount right above the grill in the front of the truck, so it's gonna be pulling in a ton of air as you drive along because it's just gonna get funneled right in. Now that's gonna push all the air through here. It's gonna funnel it into the side of the airbox. So again, you're pulling in air from the fender and from the front of the truck, and it's gonna route it through this one-piece airbox and this gigantic filter. Now, this airbox being a single piece means that there's no seams, and there's less ways for hot air to creep in from elsewhere in the engine bay. So your intake air temperatures are gonna remain nice and low because again, the air that you're pulling in is coming from the outside of the truck. Now, there is a cool little clear lid right on the top here that is already sealed in when you get it, and that allows you to check the condition of the filter without disassembling anything. And speaking of that filter, that's one of the other key pieces to this puzzle. Now, this is obviously quite a bit larger than your original factory filter, and AFE designed this setup to pack in as much surface area as they could. Now, this one clocks in at 9 inches tall, and it's what they call an inverted cone filter. So it looks like a regular cone, but right up here at the top, you can see you've got a little bit of extra space. Now, this has got a massive OA flange with a polyurethane frame for durability, and the filter consists of 3 layers of synthetic media, each one more fine than the next, so it does an excellent job at filtering out dirt and particulates. Now, AFE claims 99.2% efficiency from this filter, and given the size of the thing, I'd say that's probably pretty accurate. This has got a huge amount of surface area with the height and these deep pleats in here too. Now, this is a dry filter too, so there is no oil to contend with, which means that cleaning it is gonna be a breeze. So you can actually wash this out too. You use some nice specific cleaner for it, let it dry, and then you can pop it right in and you're set to go for a while. Now, all of that air that we've been talking about is then routed through the large diameter intake tube into your throttle body. Now, this is gonna give you some additional resonance for some cool intake sound, and it's gonna help funnel all that air smoothly into the engine itself. Now, one thing that is interesting about this kit that we don't often see with aftermarket intakes is a little resonator box. So that's gonna give you some nice sound, but it's not gonna make it too overpowering like it might be if you had just a plain old metal tube going here. Now, one other positive here with this kit is that this is a no tune required intake. So despite all of this air that you're gonna be pulling in, you don't need to invest in a custom tune or a flash tuning module to get this setup to work on your Tacoma. Just get the intake installed and you're off to the races. However, as with any other intake, you shouldn't expect huge power gains. Now, you should feel some difference in the way your truck responds. You are funneling more cooler air through the intake and into the engine, but big power gains are not gonna be the end result with any air intake. Again, you'll get some appreciable difference here though, especially with this big old scoop in the front. And of course, even though a tune is not required, I always say this, if you want to get the most out of this setup, you can always invest in such a tune or other breathing modifications like an exhaust to help make the most difference. Construction is also a highlight here. Now the intake tubing, the scoop, and the airbox are all made from roto-molded cross-linked polyethylene. And in addition to the eye-catching color of this particular kit, the material is lightweight, it's strong, and it's extremely heat resistant. Now that filter we were talking about earlier is a three-layer synthetic media, and it features progressive layering like we alluded to earlier. So each subsequent layer in here gets more and more dense to provide excellent filtering efficiency and dust holding. And again, since this is a dry filter, maintenance is simple. However, a dry filter like this one is best suited to street and lighter duty off-road uses because it doesn't have that oiled surface. Now the feature also features flexible polyurethane couplings for easy installation too, and you get two more, one for the scoop at the front and one to go onto your throttle body too. So again, everything is pretty easy to install. This is actually just gonna pop right on into the box, but we'll talk more about that in a moment. First, we gotta talk about the price. Now, for this kit that you see here, you can expect to pay about $550. Now, that does make it one of the more expensive options in the category. But if you want a true cold air intake that is actually gonna make for better airflow and one that doesn't require you to do a tune, this is definitely gonna be the way to go. Now, one of my other favorite parts about this kit is the ease of installation. We're gonna give this a 1 out of 3 on our difficulty meter, and you can expect it to take you about 1 hour to complete. Everything goes together really simply. You don't even have to do any modifications on your truck. And in fact, you really don't even have that many clamps to deal with. You really only have one right here on the outside of the filter that comes on it just like this. Filter's just gonna slide right in. And then you'd use these other couplings and this guy right here to get everything hooked up. Now, having only a few pieces again means that this entire operation is going to go very quickly and it's going to go very smoothly. So it's definitely one you can accomplish at home in your driveway or garage. With that though, let's head out to the shop and we'll walk you through the entire process.
For this install, you need a 3/8 and a 1/4 ratchet, a 3/8 extension, a 12, an 11, 10, 8, and a T20 socket, a Phillips head screwdriver, a pair of pliers, and the clip removal tool. All right, today we're gonna be installing an intake on our Tacoma, but first we're gonna watch a video to install the stock one, and we'll come back here to install a new one.
So our first step is very easy. We just have to pop off our engine cover and get that out of the way so we can access our intake and our throttle body here. Next, we can remove this hose on the side. I have a pair of pliers. Just gonna clamp that clamp down and pull back. Right, move that out of the way. Then we can disconnect our MAF sensor over here. So I just have a small flathead screwdriver. There is a clip holding in our wiring harness. I'm gonna undo that, get that out of the way. So we can press down on wiring harness here and pull back. You should hear a little click. We can get that out of the way as well. So there is another clip on the back here that's connected to our resonator. Should be pretty easy to pop out. If that gives you some trouble, you can use a trim removal tool or a flathead, but it should be pretty simple. Now we can loosen up our clamps. Then we can loosen up the one that's on our airbox and our intake tube using the same 10 millimeter socket. Should be able to wiggle off our intake tube after both of those are disconnected. Get that out of the way, and we can work on our airbox. Our next step is to take off the top of our airbox and take out our filter so we can access bolts underneath. All we have to do is push forward on these clamps and unhook them. And we should be able to very easily pop that out. This is where we can access our filter. It's just a drop-in filter, so we can take that out. And there are two bolts in the inside of our airbox that we have to remove. Now we can remove the two bolts on the inside of our airbox using a 12 millimeter socket. I'm also using a 5-inch extension to give myself a little bit of room just because this is pretty deep here. So we do have one more bolt on the outside here that's holding our airbox in place. We're gonna use that same 12 millimeter socket and extension to remove that. After those three bolts are removed, we can wiggle out our airbox and we're ready for install.
All right, before we install a new intake, we just have to swap a couple things over from the stock one. First thing is the mass airflow sensor. So we're just gonna grab our Phillips head screwdriver and take the screws out. All right, you just pull the sensor straight out. And we can drop it into our new intake. All right, we're gonna grab our supplied hardware. All right, then we're just gonna grab our ratchet with our T20 socket and tighten those down. All right, on the bottom of the factory airbox, we will need to remove our three rubber grommets and metal sleeves that are inside of them and transfer over to the new one. So some of them, you could just push the sleeve out, pull the rubber grommet out, do the same thing for the other two. All right, we can now put our rubber grommets in our new intake. And then our sleeves. We just use the table here, push those sleeves in all the way. All right, and then around the intake here, we're gonna put our rubber trim. It's gonna push over and just work your way around. All right, now we can drop our box into place. It's gonna go right into this hole here. And then it's gonna line up with the same bolts that we took out earlier. All right, we'll reinsert two of our 12 millimeter bolts that we took out on the inside of the box. Grab our ratchet and tighten them down. All right, now we can reinstall our one on our back. All right, now we can install our air filter into our air box. It's just gonna pop in and seal around the ring here. All right, now we're just gonna take our clamps over our coupler, just slide them over there for now. And we can put our coupler onto our intake pipe. And we can put it in our filter and over our throttle body. All right, now we can tighten our three clamps down, our two clamps at our throttle body, our 8 millimeter sockets. All right, and our air filter clamp is 11 millimeter. All right, while we're here, we can also plug in our mass airflow sensor and our hose. And we can pinch our clamp, or if you need to, use a pair of pliers. Pull that over. All right, now we just need to take off our plastic radiator cover. There are 7 push clips all the way across, so take them out. All right, we just take this out of the way. All right, now we have our front air ram. What we're gonna do is it just slips over the front here. And it's just gonna slip over the intake box here. Just gotta guide it into place. These two rubber grommets here will go over. All right, and then we can just reinstall our three push clips. All right, and that wraps up our install of our AFE Momentum GT cold air intake with a Pro Dry S filter colored red for our 2016 to 2023 3.5 liter Tacoma. And remember, for everything Tacoma, keep it right here at extremeterrain.com.